right, it's Wednesday morning.
0.2 miles.
It is cold as a witch's tit. Who knew that Arizona had ski resorts? I've got a mountain up here that looks like the Bush Mountain or Coors Beer. It's got snow on it. How is it that it's almost April and it's 28 degrees? I didn't pack a winter coat. It's cold. It's cold. It's cold. But I got a good night's rest, and we are going to go by the Grand Canyon. We're going to do a drive-by. We're going to drive up there. What's kind of cool, because I've been through there before. Actually, I've been right through where we are here in Flagstaff, Arizona, in 2013 when we did the infamous road trip and had to go to all the NFL markets to do NFL teams billboards. And I remember driving through to the Grand Canyon, and there's the Flintstone Village. Kayla? Huh? There's the Flintstone Village.
Let's just take a right.
Okay. It should be on the left. There's Flintstones Village. Yeah, it's like bedrock. We're going to go through Flintstones. Were you a Flintstones fan? I can't remember. Yeah, that's my day. You were more of Barney.
You're supposed to turn right.
No, it's 350 feet down there.
Wow.
So, we're going to Starbucks. Fernando and Susie. This will be the last go-around. I tried to do something neat with the Starbucks card. I was like, can you just use 50 cents on it? Just take off 50 cents. They're like, no, we have to use whatever's on the card.
Or you could just pay the amount and get 50 cents for the card.
Huh?
Pay the amount in cash.
That's what I was trying to do.
That's doing too. Dad, the line was like 50 people deep, and you're over there trying to tell a story.
I'm driving across the country here, trying to make an epic adventure. I could end up, hashtagging Starbucks and say Starbucks across the country. That shit could go viral for them. They could make a killing. Killing! Oh, it must be in Safeway. So we got a Starbucks in Safeway. Okay. All right, we're going to get some Starbucks, and then we are headed out.
Open?
At Starbucks, they should be open.
No, the market.
No, I see cars out here.
I can go in and get it because.
Oh, I can see it.
What you want, yeah.
Okay, and I can continue this then. Okay, so.
You want the biggest?
The biggest. Tell them that I'm tired of those little cups they got. Tell them they need 7-Eleven big ass coffee cups. See if they have a 5-gallon bucket that they can do me a coffee in.
Ooh, I don't want to be in the box. I'm just trying to find my card.
All right. She's camera shy. Go figure.
Do you want
a YouTuber.
A pastry or something?
A pastry?
Or a sandwich?
No. Just get me the coffee. Get me the coffee. See, this is what I'm like without coffee here. And here. Okay, so I'm dog sitting here. And we're going to be driving like crazy. So anyway. On to the Dallas Cowboys. I apologize that I haven't been able to keep up with the Cowboys much with what's going on with our team. I'm going to put this apart here. She's coming back. Chill, Leroy. Haven't been keeping up too much with the Cowboys, but this much I can tell you about. The amazing thing is I'm still looking for MG George. MG George, you owe me. Damn, this thing is clear. What the hell? This looks like ultra high def 4K. I don't know what the hell this is, but this looks really clear. Wow. I mean, I can see literally the hairs on the dog. Anyway, I'm still looking for MG George. I love it when people are a little punk ass biatch, okay? Punk ass biatch. And they end up talking all this smack. See, you know what? I will mess up. I'll get things wrong. I am a grown-ass man, and I will say I made a mistake. I screwed it up. I was wrong. I'll admit it, okay? I will. But I can't stand people that will, not own, as my wife would say, own your shit. That's right. She says own your shit. So when you leave stuff on the toilet, you own it. Clean that shit up. And that's where he should be cleaning shit up and saying, hey, Mark, you were right. Because not only did the Cowboys sign Dak Prescott, okay, not only did they sign Dak Prescott, they got that done, and they've signed some free agents. Now, the jury's out on, whether KZ is going to be good or Keanu. Whoa, Neal is going to, you know, help the team and all that. But you've seen that they have tried to go through and spread the money out as far as possible to try and get a better effect and a better team. And not only a better team, a team that understands the philosophy that they're trying to do. And on top of it, they've worked on getting younger. Because now we've gotten rid of, you know, guys like Tyrone Crawford retired and LP Lossaman's gone, you know. That we now, I want to say, and Sean Lee probably will be as well, I want to say that the Cowboys, Tyron Smith may be the elder statesman, and I don't know who else is over 30, because even our punter was in his 30s. He's gone. Our kicker may be in his 30s, but we've become a much younger team. And that's a good thing, because what you want to do is we want to find the right guys to fit your system. All of them young, so they can learn together. And as they learn and mature, they go on to that, hopefully that run, because you only have a certain amount of time with the group where you have to really start over. And when you think about the Cowboys, where they were, you know, 2014 with Tony Romo, this team is completely turned over from that. Completely, you know, with the exception of Zach Martin and Tyron Smith. Everybody else is, it's all new. So that's a good place to be with the team. So after Cowboys getting Dak Prescott done, and people joke on me when I say that the Cowboys deal was team friendly, I want you to understand the way this thing works, where they have triggers in here and have voidable years, they can manipulate this contract very easily going forward. The fact that you have $22 million for your quarterback's compensation, which is only eighth highest hit for a quarterback this year, actually bodes pretty well. When you think that the Colts last year paid $22 million for Jacoby Brissett, we're paying the same thing for Dak Prescott this year. When you think that the Eagles are spending $33 million to say, Carson Wentz, kiss my ass and get out of here, that we're doing pretty good with that. So with all that said, with all the free agent moves, with us getting the guys that we signed on the defensive line, the two safeties, Keanu O'Neill and KZ, we still have $8 million left on salary cap. And we only had to, this is crazy, we only had to do three restructures of Tyron Smith, Zach Martin, Lyle Collins. And we didn't have to cut any players. So the Dallas Cowboys deserve some credit on being able to make the moves that they did to try and build this team and keep as much of the cohesive parts of it together while getting younger. And they may not be done just yet. They may still get KJ Wright done. If they get KJ Wright into the mix, then you have to look at this and say, you know what, Jerry Jones, you have changed some. You actually have made some moves on the team where you're trying to get a better effect. This doesn't seem so haphazard way of signing guys. It seems like there's a plan with what they're trying to do. That, of course, you know, we all heard that we're going to fix the defense. We've heard that for years. But it appears that, you know, with them at least talking about trying to get the defensive tackle. I'm having a brain fart. My brain's frozen. It's so cold. It's freaking cold here. My brain's having a brain fart here. But with us trying to get the tackle that went to Kansas City, so he'll probably get a ring. And them talking to KJ Wright as well as trying to look at safeties, they are actually doing some moves to try and get a different effect. So I feel good about what we're doing. I'm not ready to get onto that Super Bowl bandwagon or anything like that. Although, we did put $100 on them, or at least Joe Boo did. So if they win the Super Bowl, that's $2,600. I get my $100 back from the Dallas Cowboys at the Super Bowl. So I hope you guys are doing good. Kind of messed up, and actually we're kind of backtracking this morning because we're going to go see the Grand Canyon. And it's about 70, 80 miles from where we are. So, and then you got to kind of come back that same way. But it'll be worth it to have that time with my daughter and things. So I'll get back home when I get back home. Hope you guys are having a great day. Be safe out there. Peace.